赛后。So it came to our attention after publishing the Riva Festival speaker video that we got a couple of things wrong. And we also gave a couple of facts about the speaker that were incorrect. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to be covering each individual speaker, the Riva Festival and the Riva Arena, in their own separate videos to really give us a chance to really run through what these speakers are about. Because they are fantastic products, and I don't think that our last video being such a brief overview of the products really did it any justice. So without further ado, let's get into the unboxing. So here in all its glory is the box for the Riva Festival speaker, and as you can see, it is pretty large. I mean, this kind of speaker would suit a living room environment down to a T. But why don't we just crack into the box straight away and let's check out what's inside. A few bits of correspondence here. Instruction manual. I think this is a warranty booklet and a Spotify advert. A bit of foam. And inside, the speaker itself. Now you'll notice most of the speaker is black. Got the grille around the entire outside of the speaker that covers up the three tweeters, the four passive radiators, and the three subwoofers that are inside as well. And they can be found on the front, the sides, and a subwoofer in the back. You've got this black glossy plastic on top, which is a very high grade. I can't see it being cracked, but certainly it could be prone to scratches and definitely fingerprints as well. This is a fingerprint magnet. On top, you've got all the buttons as well that you're going to need. So on the back from left to right, you've got an auxiliary port. You've got an optical cable, so you can plug it directly into a television or a set-top box, like a Virgin or a Skybox or Freeview box, that kind of thing. You've got a USB port on there as well, so you can play directly from a USB hard drive or memory stick if you've got music on there. And you've also got this switch here, which turns it from home network to airplane mode, which is basically a closed networks for these types of speakers. So if you're at the beach or at the park, for example, and a few of you have Riva Wind Series speakers, you can hook them all together on a closed network, so you won't need a home Wi-Fi network available to use that feature. But today what we're going to be doing is we're going to be hooking it up to my Wi-Fi network, so we just flick that back to the home. So I've got the instruction manual here, and it does seem very easy to set up. Now there's five steps. The first one is to power it on by plugging it into the wall, of course. Download both the Google Home and Riva Wand apps directly from Google Play or the App Store. As I say, we've done that already. This is the second time that we've looked at this product, so we've already got them stored on our mobile device. I am using Android, so I've opted for Google Play. There is AirPlay available as well. If you are an iOS or Apple user, you can play music over AirPlay as well. Number three is connect your wand speaker to the Wi-Fi network, reference page three. Choose a music streaming service or local content and get playing, which is step four. Number five is refer to advanced settings to enhance your wand experience. We are now currently scanning for devices, and on top there is a button which looks like a square with an arrow into it, which you use that to cycle through the various different modes that this speaker can go in. Now white, if it's flashing white, it means ready to connect to a Wi-Fi network. So I've gone into the Google Home app and it's automatically found the Riva speaker there. So let's set up the speaker and connect to the Chromecast built-in speaker. Continue that, and now it's connecting to the Chromecast built-in speaker. Now you have got other options to connect to this as well, such as Bluetooth, as I said, AirPlay, wireless networks as well is a third, and so you can hardwire into the auxiliary, the optical, or play music from the USB port as well. So you have got a number of options to really get you playing your music. So right, so it's disconnected. We are about to play a sound to test your Riva Festival speaker. Ensure that your speakers are turned on, which it is, and the volume at a reasonable level. So let's play the test sound, and I apologize in advance if this is gonna deafen you. There we go. Right, rename the Festival Riva Festival speaker. So if we put Tech Nuovo test, send Riva Festival device usage data and crash reports to Google. Yeah, why not? Connect to my Wi-Fi. So that's now connecting through the speaker directly to my Wi-Fi signal, my home broadband Wi-Fi signal. And that was pretty easy. That was just a couple of buttons. It found the speaker straight away because we set it to the Wi-Fi option on there. And at the moment, it seems like it's working. We got the test sound coming through. Everything's connected. Chromecast built-in speaker set. We've got a golden buzzer on there, or the golden buzzer, the golden Wi-Fi logo on there, which I'm assuming means congratulations. So I've connected my Google account to the app, and it came up with just a quick hint to say this is what casting is. So when you cast a speaker, it means that the sound of a particular app or software or whatever wireless device you've got connected will start playing through the speaker. So now if we go into Spotify, we should now see devices available. Go into devices available. Right, okay, so you can't use the cast feature on Spotify unless you're a premium member. Now, I'm not a premium Spotify member yet. Call me cheap. I don't care. Listening to Spotify to me is like listening to the radio. It's saying that the speaker is only available to Spotify premium members. So do bear that in mind, that if you want to use your Spotify with the speaker casting it, then you need to be a premium member. So I'm now wondering what the use of having the cast is, unless having casting is for songs and videos on your actual mobile device rather than through streaming services like Spotify or YouTube or something like that. So if we go into the Riva Wand app, which is the remote control app for this particular speaker, you can see that our speaker is there straight away. You've now got a choice. You can play music from my device or media server. So if I go into my device, there's nothing on my device. So let's go into media server, but I don't think that's not going to work because there's no media server in here. The Riva Wand will only work if you're playing music from your device, not Spotify, because that's a streaming service, not YouTube, not Apple Music, physical files that you have saved on your phone or your tablet or whatever device you've got hooked up to the Wi-Fi network. But there is another way that you can connect to the Riva Festival speaker to get around that kind of thing. So you can set, if I change that to blue, you can use the Bluetooth signal okay to pair with the speaker. So now that my phone is connected to the speaker using Spotify, you can go back into Spotify now and you can put on some rock, and you should get it through the speaker. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to run through a few track examples if I can, if Spotify will allow me, being a free member that I am. But hopefully I'll be able to give you a demonstration of what the music actually sounds like on here. The best experience for this is if you're wearing headphones, so get your headphones on if you've got any. But apart from that, just take a listen to the speaker itself. I've played this a few times with a few tracks and it is wonderful. It is such a nice little speaker to listen to. But that's thanks to the various speakers that you have dotted around the entire outside. So the subwoofers, the drivers and the tweeters that are dotted around here as well, able to pick up those pinpoint sounds. The night's a blaze, pop into the door to catch you in few days. That's the way the party rolls, that's the way the party rolls. Fancy dress invite, animals and plants, and we do it right. That's the way the party rolls, that's the way these parties rise. So straight away you've got the cymbals that you can hear. You've got this bass line as well that's not too overpowering, and it's a lovely mix between sort of all those frequencies. And the separation of instruments on that particular track was quite nice as well. As I say, you've got the hi-hats, you've got the bass guitar, you've got some kick drums going on, and then you've also got sort of the higher stringed guitar in there as well. Let's listen to some Blink 182. Again with the bass and the snares. Each individual string being plucked as well. And you just hear the vocals just come through with sort of this really nice clarity. Holocaust from the land of the lost. Behold the pale horse. Punchy bass line, and you've got the hi-hats coming through. On your radio, really clearly.
from Park Hill, the house of haunted hell. Every time you walk by, your back get a chill. Let's build, want to talk about skill. I spit like a semi-automatic in the
volumes. I mean, you think with speakers that kind of volume would just be completely destroying the actual music, but I think because the actual speakers inside the mesh are housed in such a thick, dense wooden box that it just enables you to have such greater quality with your music. And I mean, you could just hear that bass was just punching through, and then you still had the hi-hats that were still present. They weren't as loud as the bass, but they were certainly still present. And then the vocals over the top just come through crystal clear.
May I have your attention, please? May I have your attention, please?
And so that kick drum is just punchy. Bassy sounds carry very well.
Will the real Slim Shady please stand up? We're gonna have a problem here.
Y'all act like you never seen a white person before. Jaws all on the floor like Pam and Tommy just burst in the door. We started whooping her ass worse than before. They first were divorced, sewing her over furniture. It's the return of the... Oh, wait, no, wait, you're kidding.
What can I say? This speaker is absolutely phenomenal, and unfortunately, saying that, it does come with a price. Now, the speaker comes in at $499.99 US dollars. I don't know the price in pounds, but that is very high, but I think the quality that you're getting is very good. They've started with the multi-room stuff, certainly causing a bit of a disruption to someone like Sonos, who have been in the game for quite a long time now, especially the multi-room game and the wireless speaker setups. Not many people, if any, I can't even really think of a manufacturer that's come close, except Riva. They are well on their way to becoming possibly a very, very strong competitor for Sonos and the multi-room setups, because the sound out of this was just simply phenomenal. I say it's got the bass is present, it's got some really punchy bass, and then the treble frequencies on top, the sort of the hi-hat sounds and the really high notes and the quieter instruments, they're all very, very present throughout each track that we've just listened to, really stepping on each other's toes. So the bass is going to be the most overpowering thing. The bass didn't overpower at all, and it's nice to see that, because it just makes music sound so good. So let's give one more listen to a classic. So you've got that hi-hat sound. And you can just hear every single instrument. Wonderful. And then even if you pump it up louder, it's still not. You start losing it at extremely high volumes. The bass just comes through and it's a little bit shaky. It causes a bit of muddiness to the music, but it's not a lot, and you can still manage quite a loud volume without kind of distorting the track. And I think something like this would work great for, as I say, living room setups. Plug it into your TV, use it as your TV speaker as well as for your music. House parties as well, it will suit a house party down to a T, to be honest with you, depending on how big the house is. If you're only in a small house like ourselves, then you'll probably just blow out the windows by the time you get to the top volume on this. As I say, check them out for yourself. It's well worth looking into if you are looking to invest in a kind of multi-room setup. I will leave all the links in the descriptions for you down below, so you can go check those out for yourselves. If you did like the review as well, do click that like button. Do subscribe to keep up with all of our tech and gaming related videos. And also leave us a comment as well, letting us know what you think of this Riva setup and whether you think that it's going to be a Sonos killer, basically. We think it could be. We think it's certainly going to bring a lot of competition to the market on the multi-room kind of speaker setups. But let us know. Anyway, as I said, thank you very much for watching, and we will see you in the next video.
Give love, give love, give love.